What's good, y'all? It's your girl lydcenzo. I'm back here with another banger video. So the big news is that I have left Texas Southern University. It was cute for the two semesters that I was there, but yes, I am now considered a transfer student at another school. I'm not gonna tell you guys yet. I'm gonna tell you guys in a few videos down the line, but you know, everything is already in motion. And I'm just basically here to tell y'all like why I had left, what I liked and what I didn't like about the school. I know a couple of you guys have been commenting on my videos and stuff, my vlogs that you guys have watched, and you guys are telling me that y'all are coming, which is great for y'all, but I just won't be there. So here is like my personal experience of the school and why I decided to leave. First of all, my first big reason was that it was too far from home. You guys know I live in New York, so for me to just up and move over there was kind of like a big thing for me. Not that I was homesick all the time, but it's really like, I don't know if you guys know, but I did get accepted to a lot of schools, and I've never really had a top choice in school, so I didn't really have an idea of where I wanted to go. It was kind of just a random thing that I had picked TSU, and I heard that Houston was like a good, you know, place to move to. So, you know, it was kind of a random thing, and honestly, I didn't even visit the school before I decided to go there. I just went. So now that I'm there, and I mean, now that I have experienced it and I realized like it wasn't for me, like, yeah. The second reason is I'm a city girl. Like the not just the school itself, but like Houston is very, very country. I mean, obviously it is Texas, but like it's very country compared to everything else. Like I was so surprised when I seen them doing like line dances and stuff like that. Like I'm just not used to that. Even like the party scene, like it's not the vibe. Like if you, I don't know, like of course everybody has not been to a New York party, but like New York is filled with a bunch of Caribbeans, and like they don't play them type of tunes down in the South. Like, you know what I'm saying? They play like, they just don't play that type of stuff at parties, and like even the stuff that they dance to is so different. Like they don't, you know, get down and whine and stuff like that. Like they're not really about that life, so it was just very different for me, and it's not really fun for me, you know. Houston is very much like, I guess, a club scene. Like don't get me wrong, Houston is cool, like I really mess with Houston oldie, but coming from like such, shoot, we probably have the fastest paced city in the world or something like that. Like we're just very fast paced, and like moving to Houston was such a big change for me because everything is just so slow. Like so slow, I don't even know how to explain to y'all, but it's just really slow compared to New York. Everything is just spaced out. If you like to party and like you're not from New York, go to Houston. Like go to Houston. Houston has so many like clubs. Like you see so much celebrities always going to Houston. Like Houston is a vibe, like I'm not gonna lie. But for me personally, knowing the type of environment and the type of vibe that I'm used to, I just really couldn't get with it. Like that's just me. But it is very much of a party scene, so if y'all like that, y'all like that. Also, compared to like my friends and stuff who are also coming from out of state, from like different areas, they're so excited. Like they actually want to move to Houston after, you know, college is done for them, because coming from like a place where they didn't really have much going on, Houston is such like a wow moment for them. But for me, so many people come to New York, they think to go to New York, and it's like for someone who lives there to go to someone like, I mean, to some place like Houston, it's low-key a little bit of a downgrade in terms of like the, like I'm not hating on Houston, I promise, but I don't want to say it's a downgrade compared to New York or anything like that. But if y'all get what I'm trying to say, y'all get what I'm trying to say. Like it's just really not the same, and you know, I just couldn't get with it. Like, and especially being around people who like you don't have anything in common with is very, very different. Like there's out-of-state students everywhere, but at TSU it was a lot of people from like Louisiana or like other areas in Texas, like Austin, Dallas especially. There was so many people who came from Dallas. You know, it was just not people who you could really like relate to for The next thing for me at TSU was really hard for me to make friends. I had a lot of acquaintances, I will say, like, I knew a lot of people around the school, but in terms of me having actual friends, it was actually very hard for me to make, you know, to pick and choose the genuine ones. First of all, not even trying to be cocky, but when you're a pretty girl, I don't know if it's just the people in Texas or what, but like, when you're a pretty girl, other girls like to hate on you. Like, when they see that, you know, boys, like, you get the attention of boys and stuff like that, like, they automatically hate on you. Like, they do not want to be your friend. They're very, like, they're very catty and, like, jealous, and, like, they're just not genuine girls. Like, they're just messy girls. I've never gotten into any, like, problems or anything with that. Like, really, the only problems I had, well, not problems, but the only situations I had gotten into was those story times that I had told you about. If you didn't watch that, you guys can go see that. But I've never gotten into any situations with, like, girls over boys or anything like that. But it's just something that I noticed. It's just really hard to make genuine friends that way. Especially in TSU, a lot of the girls feel like they're in competition with each other. So, like, a lot of the times they really wouldn't, I mean, I don't know. They feel like everybody in TSU feels like they're a celebrity. Like, no funny. Like, they just feel so confident about themselves. And I'm not saying, like, that's, like, I'm not saying it like it's a bad thing, but because everyone, like, feels so highly of themselves, it's really hard for, you know, genuine bonds and relationships to be formed. I feel like a lot of the majority of friendships that were created on campus were built around, like, people who went out and partied all the time and stuff like that, because, you know, you would see the same groups around and stuff like that. But I wasn't one to go out and party, obviously, as I just explained to y'all. It's not the same as partying in New York. So yeah, I did not have a friend group like that. So and I'm not saying it like the Houston parties are trash. Like, I guess a lot of people enjoyed it because that's the type of vibe that they're used to. But as I said, New York is just very different. Like, I'm sure even in my next school, which I'll find out where I'm going, because I know people that go there already, it's like, I know that the vibe is, like, similar to what we do in New York, because there are people that from New York that go to that school, you know what I'm saying? So, you know, you don't really go to TSU and see a lot of people that are from New York and stuff like that to even relate to or, you know, have similarities with. So it was kind of just difficult, especially going to a school where I knew absolutely nobody going to that school at all. I didn't know anybody going there when I first went there. And that's not a very uncommon situation. I mean, if you're going across country to go to school, like, of course, that's not gonna be a common situation like people are doing. So that was also very challenging for me as well. The next thing is, there's not much campus activities at TSU. They'll constantly tell you, like, if you speak to your RAs, I know I was I always spoke to my RA about this, or like your advisor, they'll constantly tell you, like, oh yeah, you know, you just have to keep your eye out, you have to look for this, look for that. When I tell y'all, I spent the entire year looking for things and trying out new things, and I promise y'all, like, there's no legit campus activities. It's like, if you don't join a fraternity or a sorority, like, you're not doing anything for like, I promise y'all, I've been to dance classes, I've been to painting sessions, I was also in the Caribbean Student Association, we didn't really do much there either. And plus, even the Caribbean Association, no shade to them, but, like, they didn't really have any, like, events or anything like that either. Like, it was like we were just a group, and, like, to be honest, a lot of people in the group were also very uncultured. Like, we didn't have any, like, performances or anything like that. Like, and I see other schools doing that, so it kind of just reminded me that I really needed a change for. Like, I know even they were supposed to have, like, this Juve event that was canceled. Like, it was a lot of stuff that they tried to do that just didn't end up happening. So that's why I say no shade to them, but yeah, it was just not much extracurricular for me to really get into besides, you know, focusing on my academics, which made it harder for me to want to stay, because, like, if I'm not doing anything besides like working and going to school, why would I be going there and staying on campus and doing all this other stuff? Like, yeah, they did have activities during homecoming week. I can't say that in both I mean, I think fall homecoming week was definitely better than spring, but both were kind of whack to me either which way. Like, they did have events going on, I'm talking about as far as campus wise, but if you're not the type that likes to go out and party, you're probably not gonna find anything interesting for real. They have parties so many times a week, like literally. Fraternities are always throwing parties. If you're into that, they definitely have a lot of parties going on. Not just homecoming week, like throughout the year, of course, because that's not really my vibe and stuff. Like, it just wasn't given for me, like I said. Like, you know how New York is the city that never sleeps? Like, Houston sleeps all the time. Like, I'm sleeping on Houston, like, facts. Like, when I tell y'all, it's so quiet, like, outside, you're sleeping, you can hear, like, those crickets outside, like, you're, like, it's nothing really going on. Like, there was, like, a robbery outside of my window one time. That was the most excitement I got all year, like, I promise y'all. Like, literally nothing goes on. And not saying that I want to be in a dangerous environment, but, like, bro, like, not saying I want to be in a dangerous environment or nothing like that, but it's just like very slow, very quiet, like very nature filled. The air is so fresh. I remember the first time I went to Houston for school, I got sick for the first week immediately because I'm so used to this polluted air. So when I got there, it was like, yo, my sinuses was acting up, like, facts. That's not bad, like, that's a good thing. But and to be honest, it is very peaceful and relaxing. Like, it's a place that you can definitely consider to settle down in, like, after college, like, when you decide to have a family and stuff like that. I think that's a perfect environment for that. But as far as me being in college right now, I wasn't feeling that. It's also very hot in Houston. Obviously it's in Texas, but like, if y'all think New York summers is hot, like, just imagine that plus 15, 20 degrees and then, like, dry, like a dry heat. Like, I don't even know how to explain. It was just super, super hot. And then they have this season called the rainy season or the raining season, which I was not aware about or prepared for. I've never worn rain boots in my life, ever. And I was struggling to find a pair in Houston. It's this, time period for about, like, I'll say like a month or two where it's just raining every day nonstop. Like, and I'm not talking about like regular drizzles, I'm talking about pouring rain, flooding rain. Like, I'm not used to that. And then when it rains, like, you know, you have the bugs and the roaches that try to like come inside and stuff like that. Like, it just I wasn't feeling that. No matter if you keep your house clean or dirty or whatever your preference is, like, they're gonna come, like, facts. I didn't like that. And also, why is everything closed after 8 or 9 o'clock? Like, literally everything is closed. Like, you cannot find anything to eat after 8 or 9. And I'm not just talking about on TSU campus, I'm talking about, like, in general. Like, you cannot order out. Like, it just be a lot, except for like the fast food places and stuff like that. Like, there's nothing to eat. And I love to eat. Like, when I tell you I love to eat, so it's very hard for me coming from New York where you can go anywhere at any time and like get what you want to eat. Like, you can always find something that's open to eat at any time, literally. And they have so much variety of foods. Like, you can get any type of food that you want from any type of culture, any cuisine. Like, they didn't have that out in Houston, bro. Like, and I was hearing like they was eating good out there. Somebody lied because they do not be eating good out there. Like, I was expecting to be chowing down on some good soul food and stuff like that. No, like, every soul food place I tried was not good, bro. Maybe I was being pointed in the wrong directions, but it was not tasty, it was not vibey at all. And speaking of food, TSU food, the cafeteria, bro, like, I have since orientation day, I definitely had mixed emotions about the cafeteria food, because it would be like, okay, Catfish Fridays, like, that was good majority of the time. Like, it would be a couple of Fridays where they would like miss completely, but like most of the times it'd be good. And that's really the only thing I remember. I remember in the beginning of the year, they had this like salad bar, and like I was munching on them salads. Like, them salads was mad good because you could make it yourself, everything like that. I don't know what they started doing, but they just started going down, mixing up the ranch with the blue cheese, like in the different bottles, in the different containers. Like, I don't know what, but it wasn't giving after like the first 2 weeks of school. And like, it would just be sometimes where they're so lazy that they don't even have any, like, everything open, like all the stations open. They'll just have like hamburgers and fries, and yeah, it just wasn't a good place for me to eat personally. If y'all don't mind that, then go to TSU. But if you do and you care about your stomach, do that, because I promise y'all, the whole second semester, I literally cooked in my apartment. Like, I was buying groceries. I had a meal plan that I was forced to pay for. And I still kept buying groceries every single week to cook for myself, because I could not eat that food no more. And I know that people say, like, you know, the freshman 15 and stuff like that usually comes from the cafeteria food, which I can say did, I guess, attribute to me gaining weight, because I did gain weight, as y'all can see. But after first semester, like, word, they'll say like you get tired of college food fast, but it really wasn't that. It's just like, y'all are not making quality food. Like, that's really what it is. In terms of the other places they had to eat around campus, it really wasn't much options for that either. They had a Chick-fil-A, they had this thing called Bengal Burger, which had like burgers, nachos and stuff like that. That was okay. They had Starbucks, they had this other place, Einstein Bros or Bagels, something like that. That was good because I used to get the avocado toast in the mornings. And they had a Starbucks. Like, they just did not have much options besides the cafeteria to eat food. Like, if you wanted some, you know, other food, you had to really go off campus to get something to eat. One thing I did like about TSU, though, I definitely loved the library. That was my favorite building on campus. It's just so, I feel like, obviously because it's a new building, but really it just looks so modern. Like, they have all glass windows and stuff like that. It looks super, super cute. I used to go there all the time, like almost every day, to like do work or even just to chill in there. Like, they really did have a good library. And another thing I liked, I love the rec. Me and the weight room went together real bad. Like, they just had everything I needed in there. It was definitely some quality machines, because I know a lot of other schools don't really have, you know, good machines and stuff like that, but they had everything I needed in there to get what I had to get done. So yeah, I loved going to the weight room. We also had a swimming pool in there. I never went in there, but I could have. They also had a smoothie place that goes with the food I was talking about. Love that, because it was in the rec and I can just go upstairs and get my smoothies. The basketball, they had we have an actual like arena, like for basketball games, and then we had like the basketball gym in the rec, which was cool. I don't know, I just feel like when it comes to athletics, they just really gave it their all, except for the football field. It wasn't a field, like, it was really a baseball field. We did not have a football field, and it was just embarrassing. TSU versus U of H around the corner, because literally everything that they have overlooked us. Like, they don't have a football field, they have a football stadium. Like, oh my god, if I remember to put a picture, I'm gonna show y'all, because it was just so glorious. And like, you'll go down around the corner and you'll see our school, and it's just very embarrassing. Like, we just looked very poor. We looked like we just have no funding, which I guess makes sense, because we are an HB, well, I don't go there anymore, but it was an HBCU compared to a PWI. But like, they just really had us looking terrible. Like, it was just, wow. Like, and I've seen PWIs, but like that just, every time I drove past, like, it just really blew my mind, like, driving past that school. Like, they just put us to shame. It's really hard for me because I really didn't have anybody to relate to, or like, people were not interested in the same things that I was interested in. Like, I feel like a lot of people there were just so into like partying and stuff, and because I didn't really do that, I didn't really make as much friends as I could have or should have. And it's not to say that I didn't try to go out, like, even if I had to go out by myself places, like, I did that. And that was really because, you know, you never know who you can meet. And I did meet a lot of like cool people or whatever, which I was a little bit sad about leaving them. Not really sad, but like, you know, it crossed my mind. Like, I did make a few genuine friends. I did love y'all. I did try to go to as many events as I could, even if they were off campus. Like, I really did try to do a lot of things, but I just never met people who made me feel completely comfortable with being there. Or like, just after all the negatives that I was seeing, like the cons that I was noticing, it was just like nobody I was meeting was making me feel like, okay, maybe I can stick this out for another couple of years, like maybe it'll be Gucci. Like, no, like I absolutely did not really mesh with the school for real, and I tried very, very hard. So I'm really not sad about my decision for me to leave TSU. And I hope everything that I said in this video, like based on my experience, can help you guys. Because when I was first, you know, when I first decided to go to TSU, I did not have anyone to, you know, let me know their actual experience. So, you know, I gave you guys all my pros and cons, what I really did like and what I didn't like, even though most of the things I did not like. If you end up going to TSU, I really do hope you have a better experience, and I hope you like it. I hope that my advice was helpful to you. So if you guys like this video, make sure you like, comment, subscribe. Make sure you tune into my next video, because I know that you know that it's a lituation every time you feel it on Cenzo Nation, and that's on period. We out. Bye guys.